But I think it's influencing the absorption of B12 in some way that I don't really know.
Does metformin, is it doing anything in addition to mimicking a lot of the same signaling pathways and that caloric restriction does? Like, is there something additional that, you know?
Yeah, AMP kinase for sure.
Right.
So without a doubt, I mean, it's mimicking many of the pathways associated with calorie restriction and with fasting. To what degree it's mimicking that relative to, you know, a length or duration of fasting, I don't know. We're doing some work right now looking at AMP kinase and mTOR and downstream and upstream signaling insulin and these things, and trying to get a picture of this, at least in a rodent model. And then would like to ultimately replicate some of this stuff in humans. But what I think metformin would be best used maybe in pulsing it a few times a year. A lot of these things, metabolic interventions, tend to work best when you cycle them, I think. And I really have not been doing that, but I think it's a theory that I've been working on.
Why do you think
that
is?
In my scrapbook. Because your body is similar with keto adaptation, that your body can kind of reset to that level. Initially, fasting or the ketogenic diet is sort of a stress, and it can induce a hormetic effect and gene transcription, and then we sort of get used to that. You know, our gluconeogenesis is upregulated to that level, but I think it's good to maybe pick, you know, probably not a high carb diet, but maybe a paleo diet, you know, a low carb ketogenic diet, maybe something in between, and do some intermittent fasting on occasional days. So I think this promotes metabolic flexibility. It allows our body to adapt to different situations without being kind of overwhelmed by the stressor of it. So I mean, I think to some extent it is hormesis. And interestingly, metformin causes mitochondrial stress, and actually mitochondrial damage. Some researchers coined the term, you know, that it's stimulating reactive oxygen species production and causing mitochondrial dysfunction. Metformin is, and this is kind of well known in the field. So the general feeling is that, well, if I take metformin and I go exercise, why is it not killing my exercise capacity or my VO2 max or making me lethargic or tired? It's not doing that. Actually, I think it's enhancing.
Does it affect biogenesis?
It does. So yeah. So the thought that, you know, it's kind of stimulating. There's a hormetic effect. It's damaging the mitochondria. Some people believe this, and
so
you get a secondary effect through that way. Like it's kind of like an exercise drug. But I approached it from the perspective that metformin could lower blood glucose, at least if it was high, and it activated AMP kinase, and it may decrease circulating insulin. So I approached it as a cancer drug from that perspective. But the more conferences we go to, there's a plethora of data coming out of metformin, and a lot of people are studying it from the perspective of, you know, impaired complex 1 or complex 2 activity in the mitochondria. So they're looking at it from that perspective. I know. It's very interesting.